Time now for this game. Two straight comebacks for Oregon against UCLA have come up short. But they've won 16 straight home games. UCLA needs to win a road game to show they have respect. Corso's been right 14 straight times with the headgear. What happens today? Kirk, you're first.
Well, I think that the key in this football game is the defense. It can prevent the big play. That's something that has hurt Oregon at times this year. UCLA needs to start well early. That's something that has hurt them. I think the difference in the game is very simple. These people right here, home field advantage. The Ducks beat the Bruins.
Nice pick, sweetheart. Nice pick. How about this one?
Lee, the win streak's on the line here. Corso's had some close calls this season with Nebraska and Florida the last couple of weeks. He says the Bruins go down. Win number 17 at home for Oregon. All we want is a classic like the last couple of years here. Should be a wild one. Meanwhile, double barrel football on ESPN, Minnesota and Purdue in West Lafayette.
Into the top 10 after knocking off Alabama and Michigan. Now comes the tough part for Bob Toledo's boys, winning their conference opener on hostile ground. The Oregon Ducks have a school record 16-game home winning streak. Mike Bellotti's team hasn't lost on their home turf since 1997. Coincidentally, the last team to win in Eugene was UCLA.
There's never been a time in Pac-10 history where a team ranked sixth in the nation has been the underdog to a team who has not even been ranked like the Oregon Ducks are against UCLA. The Bruins have beaten two number threes. They've beaten Alabama. They've beaten Michigan. What else do they have to prove?
Well, think about this. They beat two number threes. That makes them a number six, Steve. But consider this. In 1999, they didn't win on the road. What they have to do to be a championship team is come out this year, come out today in Autzen Stadium, and win one on the road.
And Oregon's defensive coordinator, Nick Aliotti, says his greatest fear today is dying a slow death. And what he means by that is he does not want to see UCLA just hand the football over and over to Deshaun Foster.
Well, when Kellen said Deshaun Foster might get 30 to 35 carries, that's Nick Aliotti's worst nightmare. And expect Deshaun Foster to get that many carries. The offensive line is very dominant. Look for Foster to get the ball early and often.
So keep him off the field, and Oregon can do that. They are number one in the Pac-10 in scoring this year at 34 points per game. And the Ducks, well, they always have terrific quarterbacks, and they've got another one in Joey Harrington.
I think they have two great quarterbacks, both Joey Harrington and A.J. Feely. Harrington, of course, getting the start. He has a great understanding of their offense. He spreads the ball all over the field. Look for him today to try to get the ball a lot to Keenan Howery.
You're right, because they have two very good big play receivers on both sides for Oregon and for UCLA. Of course, Joey Harrington always has the hot hand. That ball will come burning into the sky for Keenan Howery. And for UCLA, watch for number three, Freddie Mitchell.
It is an absolutely spectacular September afternoon in Eugene, Oregon, where the tailgaters got here as early as 7 o'clock this morning for this 12:30 West Coast game between Oregon and UCLA, and here come the Ducks. Makes Autzen special is the crowd, the noise, and right in the middle of that volume is our Lisa Molosky. Lisa.
Steve, happy to be here. This is arguably the loudest stadium in the Pac-10. In fact, UCLA coaches believe Oregon may have the most underrated home field advantage in the country. In order to prepare for this raucous crowd, UCLA coach Bob Toledo had his players use whisper drills this week, meaning his offense never spoke louder than a whisper. He wanted his players to get used to watching for the snap of the ball. We've got our Fox sound meter with us today. We'll let you know just how loud it does get here at Autzen Stadium. And Steve, just in case I can't hear you, Tom and I have worked out a couple hand signals. He'll fill you in.
Well, he's the quarterback, so he is always audibilizing me to change plays. And there is go. Mike Bellotti. He says they have the best stadium on the West Coast. And Mike says, we believe it. Our fans believe it. We want our opponents to believe it. 20 over 500 in his 5-plus seasons here in UCLA. Won the toss and deferred to the second half. And the return man is Keenan Howery. And they look like they wanted to run something to the Bruins. And now it's Oregon football near the 20-yard line. For the Oregon Ducks, they will start at quarterback Joey Harrington. Three of his four interceptions were against Wisconsin. And he threw for 360 yards in that game. His backs and receivers, Maurice Morris, the best junior college running back in the nation last year. Howery and Tucker are their home run threats. And the offensive line, Jim Adams, Lee Gundy are playing with broken hands. Jeff Austin is the new center. Ryan Schmidt and Joey Forster are the guards. Joey, the junior from Portland Central Catholic High School. And he will give the football immediately to his running back. And this is Maurice Morris going off the right side. They have a huge line. Sean Phillips will start over Kenyon Coleman, who's out with a knee injury. Fletcher Leslie are the middle guys. Rusty Williams is a cap. Williams is a captain and a ferocious leader. They're linebackers. Robert Thomas, the man in the middle, is outstanding run stuffer. Tony White, brilliant in the outside. Ricky Manning might be the most underrated cornerback in the nation. Marcus Anderson moves from corner to safety, and he is a wow kind of player. On first down, 12-yard run by Morris. Now Harrington will play action. With plenty of time, Joey looking. Marshawn Tucker, incomplete.
He sure did. You saw the arm strength of Joey Harrington just getting the ball out deep. I think that's a good play by Jason Bell. He was stumbling a bit. Marshawn Tucker, even though he's really almost tackled by Jason Bell, that's a great play by Bell. And they don't flag on that play.
They picked up the flag. Second down, 10 yards to go. UCLA showing blitz. Instead, it goes to Maurice Morris. And Morris off the right side for just a couple of yards. Maurice, the 6-foot junior from Chester, South Carolina, who was the top-rated junior college recruit in the nation last year. He has run for 334 yards already this season.
It's amazing how Mike Bellotti finds him. He's in the backfield right now on 3rd and 7 for the Ducks, but this is where Harrington's at his best in third down situations.
UCLA blitzes Ryan Neese. Morris off the right side, and he slams past the 45 for the first down.
Take a look. Just a draw play. Harrington goes back. Nice job on the right side of the offensive line. Big number 76, Lee Gundy. And then you see Morris's speed able to get up the field. Eludes the tackle of Marcus Anderson. And there you see some of the numbers on Maurice Morris. First three games, consider this. He came in fall camp as a newcomer to the program.
I like Bellotti's guts on 3rd and 7, still running that football. Marshawn Tucker pass midfield, 45, and very close to a first down. And Howard now will go to the right side of Joe Harrington. You see where they need to go for the first down. Less than a yard. Maurice Morris with the first down.
Well, and it's a patchwork offensive line, Steve. You see Morris, look at his JC career, 3,700 yards rushing, 45 touchdowns. That's why Coach Bellotti spotted him as the top recruit in the nation.
92 yards against the Wisconsin defense that returned 8 starters, and they were number 1 in the Big Ten. They swing it back looking for Morris, and he had a host of green jerseys in front of him, but Harrington overthrows. Harrington throws behind Justin Peel. The pass was too tall. Now it's third down, but that is twice in a row he has hit open.
The arm strength of Harrington, you see when he comes out, his nerves are probably a little excited right here. You tend to throw the ball a little bit high, but right there they're incorporating the tight end into this great offense. And Justin Peel goes about 6'5", 250, unable to pull it down, and he would have had some running room had he come down with the ball.
They will send Morris, though, wide to the right side and keep Josh Line in the fullback to block. Blitz from the corner. Harrington is sacked.
Zone territory. Marcus Anderson, watch him blitz from the strong safety position. He really just eludes the blocker up top, and he's having such a great year. He comes in tied for the lead in total tackles for the Bruin defense. On the 44.
He will punt it. And he just pooches it towards the corner. That's a wise move. It goes out of bounds near the 10-yard line. Let's see where they mark it. Possibly for UCLA, Ryan McCann has thrown for 536, but the big point, one interception in 3 games. His backs and receivers, we told you about Deshaun Foster, Freddie Mitchell, Brian Poley-Dixon. They can go the distance every time they touch it. Very good offensive line. Troy Danoff under-entered at center. The two seniors are the guards in Cabrera and Pola. A fumble, a flag goes down. Someone either came across the line of scrimmage defensively too early.
You saw the noise factor just confusing UCLA. I think it confused the front of Oregon as well. It appeared as though they jumped.
Dead ball. False start.
And everyone on the snap of the ball has to turn their heads in and watch the snap. They cannot hear.
Ryan McCann calls timeout. They weren't even set up properly. 16 straight home wins here. And when we were at practice yesterday, he gathered all the troops together right at midfield. And the last thing he told them was, gentlemen, you have to believe that that crowd will help us win the game tomorrow against UCLA. And they will get after the Bruins right here. Fletcher in motion. Deshaun Foster, nothing. And defensively, they have moved Jason Nicolau from end to tackle and Seth McEwen as a defensive end because they wanted the best run support for Oregon defensively. Linebackers watch for Matt Smith. He goes 6'4", 245 pounds, a former professional baseball player with Kansas City. Rashad Bowman, best cover cornerback. Steve Smith, a big physical corner, going against the tall UCLA wide receivers. They swing it out Foster. He breaks one tackle and is hammered out of bounds near the 15. And Mitchell coming out of the game. Blitz. McCann in trouble. Rolling left. Incomplete. Fourth and eight. Dixie, sixth in the nation. 46 yards per punt. Howry will take it. Keenan cut down near the 41-yard line. Steve Busiak, Tom Ramsey, Lisa Miloski here at Autzen Stadium. And there's a look at Eugene, Oregon. Temperature outside 65 degrees. There is a slight breeze blowing in the face of the Oregon offense. They have it. First down at their own 46-yard line. Harrington will throw. Incomplete. Marshawn Tucker. Harrington incomplete in his last three throws. Touchdown passes
holding
last week.
On a forward pass play, across the line of scrimmage against the defense, that's 10 yards, automatic first down.
They really believe in this young man, Joey Harrington. His father, John, was the Ducks quarterback in 1966 to 69. And Len Casanova, the old coach here, he gave a letter of intent to John when Joey was born. And here he is, 20 years later, and leading the Ducks at quarterback, so the letter of intent proved out.
But I think Oregon has the right game plan right now. It spread UCLA's defense out a little bit.
Morris, big hole, first down, 32-yard line.
Jim Adams just gets a pin, and they're able to kick out the end, and all of a sudden you see Morris, his great speed, watch the hit by Marcus Anderson come over and just deliver the knockout. Oh!
51 yards rushing on six carries. Fake reverse. Harrington steps up. Almost intercepted by Jason Zdenek.
We'll let it roll. UCLA once again bringing a lot of pressure. But watch the corridor. We'll slow it down right here. Watch the corridor right here. He can run for 15 yards. But he ends up throwing the ball incomplete. Nice play by Zdenek.
They'll run Morris. He cannot escape this time as UCLA smelled it out, and it'll be a loss of 4 or 5 yards.
I'd still be looking for Keenan Howry.
He's in the slot. Harrington will dump it off Morris. He's got room. First down, Morris inside the 20.
Jeff Tedford, the offensive coordinator, what they do, they go slot left, and then all of a sudden they sneak out the back to the right, and he gets some nice blocks. Morris up the field, finally tackled by Jason Stevens as he comes over from the safety position, but a nice play call, as you said, Steve.
First down, UCLA 16. They're going to run the reverse, and here it goes, diving for the end zone, Jason Willis.
Body guy, 6'1", 200-pound guy, takes it on the reverse, and he just flies down the sideline. Another great call. You see a screen call. You see a reverse in the red zone.
They'll go double tight end. Jason Line is the fullback. They give it to Line. He leaps the top. He fumbles the football.
And watch Thomas. If you can't see him, hit him in midair. Oh, what a stick by Robert Thomas.
Why did he stretch that football on first and goal?
Line tried to break the plane of the goal, Steve. If they break the plane of the goal line with the ball, it's a touchdown. But Robert Thomas was like a stealth bomber over the top and just crushed him.
I believe they'll give it to the running back this time, Maurice Morris. No, Harrington will try and drive in himself, and he is in. Oregon scores.
And you're able to with a big-bodied quarterback. Joey Harrington takes it down the line, tries to option the end, and you see he's met by a whole host of defensemen. Zdenek right there, Ryan Neese, but he broke the plane of the goal line. 6 points, Ducks.
Oregon off to the early start. One of UCLA's keys was to quiet the crowd. They have been unable to do that. Oregon takes the early 7-0 lead on the UCLA Bruins. UCLA has won the first three games this year, despite giving up the first touchdown in all three games. But that was at the Rose Bowl. Now Dan Katz will kick off to Tab Perry. Perry fumbles, and he is drilled by Oregon.
Keith Lewis, they do such a great job on special teams. Tom Osborne, the special teams coach, they thrive as this on this as part of their game. But watch Keith Lewis, the special teams hero. He almost makes a huge play, comes up with the ball. Steve, once again, the sound, a huge factor.
Deshaun Foster, he will lose yardage. Garrett Sable, number 35, the senior from Buena Park, California. Defense, Tom, that lost not only 8 starters, but 8 leaders last year. And Nick Aliotti has done quite a job to bring him back so early.
Nick Aliotti, the defensive coordinator, he's really the heart and soul of that defense. He used to be down on the sideline, hopping and skipping and jumping around. Now he's up in the press box. I asked him, how's he handling it? It's tough on him, but he could be a little more strategic up in the box.
A loss of 4. McCann to the air. Intercepted. Rashad Bowman. Bowman inside the 25 to the 20. Flags after the play.
Defense just suffocating right now. They're putting the heat on McCann. He's forced into a bad throw. He throws it really into double coverage. The ball glances off Freddie Mitchell right into the hands of Rashard Bowman. Bowman does a great job.
Dead ball foul against the offense. The return team, that'd be personal foul, 15 yards from a dead ball spot, first down.
Sounds like you want to go Oklahoma Sooners of the 1970s. Here is Maurice Morris, who has really out-dueled Foster so far. Harrington, play action. Looking deep. Keenan Howry, broken up beautifully.
Ricky Manning has been playing stellar out on the corner for UCLA. Watch, just one-on-one with probably Oregon's best player, Keenan Howry. He's able to break on the football.
Now 3rd and 3. UCLA showing a 4-man rush. Harrington will try and scramble for it, and he was looking for the quarterback draw. But right there is Anthony Fletcher in his face. Long in his career from this distance. He hits it long enough, but no good.
Interesting to see.
7, excuse me.
And I'm sure Bilotti right there, if he had it to do over again, he would absolutely go for it on 4th down there.
Morning madness to get you ready for the kickoff. Here in Eugene, Oregon.
3 straight times and see if I couldn't get a first down.
He's carried the ball 3 times for minus 4 yards. Play action. They will throw the football. Brian Poley-Dixon.
And the challenge is this. When you stack as many guys as Oregon is in the box, right there, Ryan McCann just tosses it outside one-on-one. Number 13, Brian Johnson on Poley-Dixon. Poley-Dixon's a great big target. 6'5", 206.
Last week in the second half, UCLA outstanding. but very poor. And Bennett will dive, and it appears that he will get that first down.
Ryan Mitchell is here on the sideline. Actually, they took the ice off. They have taped him. They're putting a special brace on, and they are expecting that he will return, maybe even this half.
Right now, Johnson playing strong safety. And did someone move? Gold Beach.
Ball park. On the offense. The down remains one.
The corners are on an island. It's eight in the box.
Well, it's all nine.
Yep. And another mistake. He is yet to play consistently from beginning to end.
Ball park.
Redshirt sophomore from Westlake Village, California. Another flag goes flying. Foster is knocked down at the 32, 50 yards.
Foster. Down remains one.
And now it's only getting louder.
UCLA with 20 penalties in their first three games this year. They have five already today. 58 all last year, tied for the fewest in the Pac-10.
And this is about two teams that know each other very well. It comes down to execution. You have to execute, whether there's noise or not, you have to execute your offense if you're UCLA.
Freddie Mitchell was wide open. He has not dropped a pass this year, and he just dropped his
can. Is struggling somewhat just seeing the ball down the field.
McCann downfield, incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Gabe Grecian. Wow, Wisconsin, another top team ball, number seven. The number seven team in the nation knocked off. Can Oregon do it against the number six team in the nation? They're leading UCLA. A quick kick. Boy, this helps out. On third down, they punt it inside the 30-yard line, and Oregon will have their longest field position of the game. Defensive line coach Steve Greatwood talking with his Oregon Ducks defensive line on their pressure they must get on McCann. Oregon with the lead.
Oregon offense has been very productive here in the first quarter.
Particularly new tailback Maurice Morris, who takes over for one of the great backs in the last 10 years, Reuben Drones. Here is Joey Harrington looking deep, going home run. Keenan Howry incomplete.
Hard to pick on someone else when you can't go to either side. You see both of them sitting there.
They will run Morris. Maurice trying to get outside. He will not. Beautiful read by Ken Coker, the junior from San Diego, California.
As you said, he comes off. He's right in the interior. Coker, you see him fight off the tackle. He bench presses a house.
On third and 10. See if the Bruins blitz. Right now, they're showing a blitz from the left side, and they will bring it. Harrington rolling away from it, throwing downfield. Howry almost picked off. Marcus Anderson had it skip off his shoulder pad. Who is a Ray Guy candidate. Goes to the top punter in college football this year. Low snap. Gore hits it well. Ricky Manning will let it roll in. Ricky then picks it up. The crowd again picks up. They know they have been a factor early in this game. Deshaun Foster, maybe 1 or 2 yards.
He'll keep the defense off balance a little bit, but look at the Oregon defense. They're stacking nine guys in the box. They're saying, hey, throw it.
Let's see if they go Foster again. No play action. They will dump it off to the running back, Ed Uramia Stansberry. Third down, 5 yards to go. McCann throws again over the head of Freddie Mitchell. Nate hits it off the right side of his foot. Howry will let it go, and it bounces inside the 20. So not a bad punt by Bixby.
UCLA's played pretty good pass defense against Oregon, with Oregon just running two-man routes.
Maurice Morris cuts to the outside. Morris slams near the 25, a gain of 7-8 yards, but this kid is impressive. Maurice Morris with over 60 yards rushing. You can barely see the beautiful Willamette River. It cuts through two buttes, Skinner and Spencer, that frame the city of Eugene on the north and southern borders. You know where they got the name Eugene? Eugene Skinner, one of those buttes is named after him. He is one of the founders of this community.
I'm surprised you know the territory so well. When we were driving yesterday, you didn't know if we were going north or south.
Watch those rush yards, a big goose egg for UCLA.
And Deshaun Foster is their man, and he has come up with minus yard. Maurice Morris, first down and more to the 34, and a great tackle by Ricky Manning.
Take it for granted that your great player is going to make plays, but nice little deception right there. Morris goes the other way, and then you see Manning's closing speed. He just comes like a rocket, able to make the hit right on Morris's knee. And, you know, they don't play on a real friendly surface here. This turf is like playing on 40 grit sandpaper.
Three wide receivers. Harrington will deliver, and he gets it to his tight end, Justin Peel. Muscles his way past the 45-yard line to the Bruin 42.
Justin Peel does a great job. It's just a quick drop back, three-step drop. UCLA had a corner blitz on that time, bringing people from the outside, but you see Peel's strength and his wheel. Watch him right here. He just makes a little breakout. The ball's delivered right on time, and then he just knifes between the defenders and puts the pressure on the UCLA defense.
Mixed by Oregon offensively. Maurice Morris trying to get outside. Ooh, they almost got him by his face mask, and they did, as here come the flags.
See him one-on-one in the open field right there. He grips a face mask.
And he didn't let go. That's why it's 15 yards.
Automatic first down.
Yeah, not incidental by any stretch.
I've seen Oregon's running game just really chew up the Pac-10. And they've done it with junior college players, Saladin McCullough a few years ago, Ruben Drones the last two seasons, and now Maurice Morris. Harrington with a blitz on. Joey gets it to his tight end, LaCorey Collins, but it'll be no gain.
It was Robert Thomas, number 8. See him on the blitz, and he just puts the heat on Joey Harrington, forces Harrington into a bad throw.
50% on the season. Blitz. Harrington dumps off. It is caught by Maurice Morris. Not much there.
Marshawn Tucker originally lined up in the backfield. Then he spread this out there.
Harrington looking. He will scramble and run. But he cannot free himself.
Thomas, watch his reaction. He's in kind of a spy technique right there, and he's just sitting around waiting for just that, the quarterback to appear, and then he just comes up with a nice sure tackle.
Missed earlier from 44. Plenty of distance and no good. Mike Bellotti's Oregon Ducks have won 16 consecutive home games, but the last time they lost at Autzen Stadium was against UCLA in 97. Achilles Smith had a terrific game, both passing and running the football as he dashes in here. But Cade McNown would match him play for play, and he would slide into the end zone. UCLA would tie it, and then from 55 yards out, Chris Saylor for the lead, a later score, and UCLA would win it 39-31. The longest home winning streak belongs to Marshall at 32, then Florida State, then Kansas State, Texas A&M, the Ducks with 16 in a row, and they have a 7-0 lead on the number 6 team in the nation, the UCLA Bruins, who are back on offense with Ryan McCann. McCann with all kinds of time. Completes the pass to Freddie Mitchell out of bounds. Well, he dropped one earlier, and last week he told the receivers at the halftime they'd better catch the ball, or he was going to tell Ryan McCann to throw all of them to him. He dropped one earlier in this game. Deshaun Foster, nothing.
Really came crashing in. If you watch to the right of the screen, right up here, watch Steve Smith. He comes in and just lowers the boom on Deshaun Foster. They're doing a great job on first down on Deshaun Foster. They're really committing a lot of guys in the box, and they're making a second and long situation for Ryan McCann to throw the ball.
McCann is blitzed. They throw it to Mitchell and Freddie out of bounds, but man. Third down. Well, Saul Patu came across. So did Jed Boyce. And when the flags come so late, usually that's against the defense.
Dead ball, false start on the offense. Down remains three.
And I'm sure Bob Toledo is saying, why did the flag come out so late? They were already in our offensive backfield.
Yeah, when you're at third and three, I believe it's the center, Danoff, he moved, and the defensive line's reading it. Looked like no one else moved, but that's the fifth movement call on UCLA prior to the snap of the ball. Now it puts UCLA in a tough third and eight position. They had a third and three, but now it's a much tougher call for McCann.
Four wide receivers set. Blitz, McCann, Holy Dixon, first down.
One of the attributes of a great quarterback, standing in the pocket when you know you're going to get drilled.
Wow.
McCann took his shot. Garrett Sable came off the corner.
He'll throw it again. And now Ryan slips and falls, and he is limping as he gets up.
Well, the field is not a good field. You're going to see McCann, a great view from behind when he just tries to make a move and then slips. A knee goes down. He's down right there. Grabs that hammy.
As again, it is second down and long. 16 yards to go. Motion Stansberry. Ryan all kinds of time. Downfield incomplete. Intended for tight end Mike Seidman. Steve Smith on the coverage.
And is committing to the field turf here. A year from now, you see that turf in a lot of places, but you see the players slipping a lot. I mean, I'm telling you, that's 40 grit sandpaper there. That's not fun to slide on. They water the field down before the game. Another tough third down for Ryan McCann. Third and 16.
Three wide receivers. McCann. Almost picked on.
Well, you see, that's what makes third and 16 so hard. You got to get the ball up the field, and then that's just good scouting. Steve Smith sits on the comeback route. He breaks on the ball right in front of Poli Dixon. He's got to come back. If you're Poli Dixon, you got to come back and break that one up.
Dixie end over end. Terrible punt. Oregon will have strong field position when we come back. Ryan McCann has struggled early.
Thus far, Oregon's done a great job executing their game plan. They've kept the crowd in the game, too. You see first downs for UCLA, only 0.2. Ouch.
Harrington to Morris. Cut down. Oh, what a nice play by Tony White, who really tackled him with his leg.
Well, Steve, Tom has been talking about the turf. It is actually called Omni turf, and it is on sand. In fact, 7 tons of sand underneath this turf. About 2 hours before the game, they've been watering it. They watered it for about 30 minutes. They'd like to do it between 30 minutes and an hour before game, so it softens things up a little bit. Tom, Steve?
Turf. Dave Heakey, the associate director of athletics, took us out to Eugene Country Club yesterday. It's grass, and it's beautiful. I know they can grow grass up here.
They have a wonderful agriculture program here at Eugene. Harrington with time going downfield deep. Sonny Cook incomplete. He had just an edge on Ricky Manning, and then Manning closed on him at the end.
And that Oregon offensive line trying to keep that aggressive defensive line of UCLA out.
On the offense, penalties declined. Down will be three.
I would expect them to bring a little heat this time on Harrington.
Right now showing four-man front. And that's all they'll rush. Harrington scrambling left. Fletcher in pursuit. And Joey is very close to a first down. Let's see where they mark it. It appears that he may be a couple of yards shy, as Joey saying, I never touched the white.
Great push by the front four of UCLA. Ken Coker, number 97, trying to get the motor running in pursuit. And he did well enough. Yeah, you see him step out. That's a nice call by the line judge.
This year, I just think it's freshmen, sophomores growing up. They've got a ton of juniors and seniors who are really good and really fast. Look at this play. Curtis Dorr with a wonderful punt. And Sonny Cook.
That's his job. He can catch those balls. Even though he doesn't catch it, he stops it. Short of the goal, again, pins UCLA deep in their own territory. And now you get to bring the crowd back in the game.
And Mike Bellotti feels that he has the best special teams coach in the game, and Tom Osborne. We saw how hard they worked on that part of the game yesterday. Foster. Deshaun still on his feet. Near the 6-yard line, where he's finally hogtied and thrown down by Michael Collier. It must have simply fallen out. of an official because it was on the green. Second down, 5 yards to go. Foster goes in motion. McCann going downfield. Freddie Mitchell with the first down catch, then fumbles the football. It goes out of bounds.
One of the top receivers in the country. You see Mitchell Bowman has great position. But that's where the defender just doesn't keep his eye on the football.
First down at their own 41. Tab Perry motion. Foster. Big hole. To midfield. Foster slips and falls, or he could have been gone.
Line of UCLA. Now they're starting to gel right here. Watch the guard end up coming around. Jeremiah Stansbury, the fullback, a great block. And then it's Deshaun Foster just running through. And he's just got such great acceleration. But Foster again slipping on that turf.
This drive started at their own 2-yard line. Deshaun will keep it. Nothing. Chased out by Brian Johnson. Second and 10. McCann play action. Scrambling left. He dumps it off to Deshaun Foster, who only gets a yard or two. Great coverage by Steve Smith. For Deshaun Foster, one of the Heisman Trophy candidates this year, 422 yards against two terrific defenses, Alabama and Michigan, 375 yards and 99, but that was because of an injury. Three wide receivers set. Blitz. McCann steps up. He's got a man open. Incomplete. John Dubrovic was wide open.
Boy, McCann, they bring the heat right up the middle. Watch the Oregon defense. They're bringing number 56, Michael Callier. McCann does a great job. Resets his feet. Fires the ball deep to Dubrovic. And it goes right through his arms.
Right there. Drew Bennett is in at quarterback. He gives it to Deshaun Foster. And Foster races for the first down just barely as he's marked out of bounds at the 30-yard line. Matt Smith was defending him on the play. Option. And a bad pitch, and Foster can't cover it. Oregon football.
Bringing quarterbacks in and out, I disagree with completely. Drew Bennett's, he's not a quarterback. He's a utility guy. He can sneak over, but he's not an option quarterback. He gets hammered. Bad pitch on the ground. The Bruins lose the ball, and Deshaun Foster just unable to make a play. The pitch was nowhere near him.
With a tackle in his face, he pitched it, and it was a very poor pitch. Harrington, Maurice Morris, Tony White wraps him up at the 45, gain of 4.
Maurice Morris, thus far on the day, he's hit UCLA's defense all over. A little farther out here, 6 carries, 38 yards. Doing a nice job. Once he gets the ball, he's so explosive.
Harrington flips it, Marshawn Tucker, and Tucker breaks the tackle. He has the first down. Keenan Howry goes in motion. Ricky Manning will follow him. Maurice Morris sweeping. Look at that speed, and look at Ricky Manning. He is from sideline to sideline. Second down. Harrington downfield. Is that ball intercepted? No.
Field. See, pretty good pocket. He fires it low, trying to get it to Justin Peel, the big tight end. Peel never sees the ball. Denick unable to come down with the ball's on the ground.
Three wide receivers set. Willis at the bottom of your screen. Blitz on from Robert Thomas. Harrington will run, and he's still on his feet, lunging forward. He will not get the first down. Comes up about 2 yards shy.
Go with the guys. They're probably going to call timeout, which is probably a good move by Oregon. With 4:37 left, talk about it.
Oregon,
get to the right play.
First time out of the half.
Here we are, fourth down and 2 yards to go. Oregon going for it. They pitch, and they will run the football.
and it's a first down for the Oregon Ducks. Jason Willis, the wide receiver, stayed in the backfield, and it is Willis carrying the football for the second time today for a first down.
Now it's called a tendency breaker. That's a wide receiver right there lining up in the backfield. He becomes the pitch man on the option. Great hands. Willis picks it up out of the air and then just bruises ahead and inbounds for the first down. Ryan Neese there to make the tackle.
And you love those Jason Willis stories because he is a former walk-on, not a recruited walk-on. He just walked on because he wanted to come to Oregon. Look at that. And the time of possession clearly in the Ducks' favor. Keenan Howery with the catch. Howery breaks the tackle, and then he goes down at the 19-yard line. Second down. Harrington with time. Again, he'll swing left. Howery, first down, inside the 10-yard line.
Able to move around. You see, just feels the defense right there. He got a nice little screen. I don't want to say screen, but Keenan Howery's right there. 29 catches as a true freshman a year ago. He came out of Los Alamitos High. Great program down there in Southern California.
And now Howery, who replaces Tony Hartley as the guy to go to in their wide receiving offense. Maurice Morris cutting left, back right. UCLA smelled it out, and a great defensive play by Sean Phillips, who had to replace Kenyon Coleman. Three wide receiver set. UCLA blitzes. They give it to Morris. Not much.
Defensive line plays well. Keep an eye on what that does to the linebacker. It should free up the linebacker to make some plays. The fullback comes low on him, but Tom is such an instinctual player. Great at the point of attack, able to keep his pad level down, make the hit for UCLA.
Timeout called by Oregon. Did that against Michigan, down by 10 in the third quarter. UCLA, though, with problems early in this game. One off the hands of Mitchell. One off the hands of Dubrovic, and then the fumble by Bennett as he tossed it away to Deshaun Foster. Oregon starting their drive and trying to capitalize on it.
Well, there's a lot more happening here.
Third and goal from the 9. Blitz, Harrington throws, incomplete. And Oregon has 3 more. Yard run by Joey Harrington, a 26-yard field goal by Josh Frankel. Josh Frankel had a low snap, but his holder, Joey Harrington, handled it well, got it down, and they go 50 yards in 4:46. So look at that. They lead the Pac-10 again in kickoff coverage. That's Coach Tom Osborne. Perry from the 1. Perry, well, this is a fine return out to the 30-yard line, 29 yards in return.
Watch him as he runs down the field, number 16. One of the big performers there that makes a lot of those big hits. He got mauled.
Here comes UCLA back to live action. Deshaun Foster breaking a tackle, and Deshaun maybe just heating up.
Kept his knees going and made a big play for the Bruins. They need another one now.
44 seconds left. Foster, the call, the carry. There comes Oregon. Foster still on his feet. He should have lost about 5. The middle of the clock run out.
I think you go for the first down here.
They will not. Will they get it to Foster? And Foster muscles forward. And I believe he's got the first 10 points per game. They've been shut out thus far. McCann looking downfield. Dumps it off Jermaine Lewis, incomplete. The coverage was from Matt Smith. And Oregon's defensive coordinator, Nick Aliotti, who left UCLA 2 years ago, has to be so proud of the fight of his Ducks in the first half of this game at Autzen. They have shut out a fine offense. McCann will take a chance. Incomplete. And the half is over. Oregon, who came in the favorite to beat the number 6 team in the nation, has a 10-0 lead over UCLA. Just southwest of Autzen Stadium here in Eugene, Oregon. where the Oregon Ducks have a 10-0 lead over the number 6 team in the nation, the UCLA Bruins. You see them right there with Oregon.
Yeah, when you look at the stats, Steve, you know, the time of possession, number one for UCLA, it's low turnovers, two turnovers, and you mentioned the rushing yards, only 22 rushing yards for UCLA.
Again, UCLA won the toss of the coin in the first half and deferred to the second half, so they will get the football first offensively. Tab Perry will give way to Jermaine Lewis, and Lewis straight up the field, and Jermaine past the 30 to the 31-yard line. The crowd has been a major pain for Bob Toledo and a major delight for Mike Bellotti. Ryan McCann stays in at quarterback. Deshaun Foster, again, this is a young man who was held to 12 yards in the first half against Michigan last week, ran for 83 in the second half.
UCLA able to generate some first down yardage, even though it's only 4 yards, it's a lot better than what they were averaging in the first half.
McCann, play action, pressure on him, dumps it off Freddie Mitchell. Mitchell breaks a tackle, and Freddie has a first down inside Oregon territory. They'll run it on first down here, and again, blasting in was Oregon's defense. Play action on second down. McCann throws it away.
The biggest thing for him, he converted a lot on third down in the second half. Right now, another third and long, third and 11 for McCann.
He completed 6 of 9 third downs last week. McCann with pressure all over him, lays it up in the air for Paulie Dixon, and it's broken up by Oregon. Oh, what a play by Brian Johnson, who's only 5'9" tall, and he went up with 6'5", Paulie Dixon.
The pocket breaks down for McCann. He ends up rolling left. Great pressure that time. Wes Mallard delivering a hit on McCann. The ball flutters, and she said Paulie Dixon not able to get up and make the catch.
They have not given up one big play to UCLA. The punt, Keenan Howery will let it go, and it sails into the end zone. It took him on one touchdown drive of 54 yards in the first half. That resulted in a Harrington one-yard run. The field goal came from Josh Frankel from 26 yards out. Maurice Morris is stuck. Not only at the line of scrimmage, he is dropped 2 yards, 3 yards back. And Rodney Leslie, the redshirt freshman from Bakersfield, California, with a terrific hit on the junior college player of the year a season ago.
Steve, in the first half, it was really Joey Harrington able to distribute the ball all across the field. Take a look at between the wide receivers, tight ends, and running backs. Remember, a nice screen pass right here to Maurice Morris. That led to a touchdown. Just a great call in the red zone by Jeff Tedford.
Second and 12. Blitz from Marcus Anderson, picked up by the running back. Marshawn Tucker caught it and dropped it as he was drilled by Jason Bell.
Watch Harrington. He ends up little move pocket once again. They do such a great job moving the pocket, buying a little more time to throw. And then he just fires a rocket out to Tucker. But watch the close on the ball right there. Jason Bell is going to be a player that plays at the next level. Great size, 6'1", 180-pound senior for UCLA.
Only played 2 games last year because of injury. Marcus Anderson did not play last year because of disciplinary reasons. They blitz Ricky Manning this time, and Harrington overthrows a wide-open Marshawn Tucker.
And Steve, this is where UCLA can get a lot of help from Ricky Manning, giving him a big return here.
Dorr hangs it up. Manning from the 45. He threw up that hand very late, no flag, as he fair catches it at the 46-yard line. Last week, John Navarre gave him a 10-point lead in the first half with this touchdown pass to David Terrell. But McCann with a solid second half, completing 15 of 21. They took the lead on this touchdown to Uramia Stansberry. Then Jason Stevens would seal it with the interception. The Bruins would knock off number 3 Michigan despite trailing by 10 points in the third quarter. And here they are, down by 10. So they're ready for the national championship, Tom. And he said, we have not executed like we need to make a run at it. McCann throws. Did no, Paulie Dixon pulled it off the turf.
Third down. Four wide receiver set. Oregon showing blitz. And here they come. Paulie Dixon did not get the first down. He's about a yard shy. There is a late flag, and it might be against Oregon.
Roughing the passer against the defense. 15-yard previous spot. First down.
Excuse me, it was Collier with the late hit and Sable on the tackle of Paulie Dixon.
And McCann stood in the pocket well in the first half, took some shots.
From the end of the run.
McCann replaced Corey Paws after the first series. An injury against Alabama. Settles in as quarterback. Led him to three wins this year. Play action pass. Going deep. Incomplete. Freddie Mitchell did not have control as he was pushed out of bounds. Rashad Bowman with the coverage. Hey,
great protection this time. First down, play action. There you go. Drive the ball deep. McCann gets it out nicely, and Freddie Mitchell gets away with a little bit of push off. He comes down and, whoa, nope. That's a great
on
call. That's
that
a
is.
Great call by the referee. He doesn't have full possession. Watch his foot.
Oh, he does have full possession. He did not juggle it. That's a touchdown. Second and 10. Foster. Nothing.
See, did the ref miss it? The left foot, sure enough, right there. That's the foot. That's what you need down. The second foot is out of bounds. Flat out missed the call. Freddie Mitchell got away with a push-off, so if you're UCLA, you call it a push. You still got to line up on third down, third and nine.
Play action will work. They're bringing the red dog. McCann in trouble, dumping it off. Nothing. Fourth down and nine from 46 yards out. It is on the way, and it is good. So UCLA came back last week with three long touchdown drives of 80, 80, and 85 yards against Michigan to win. Here's a kid who threw for 360 yards against a terrific defense in the Wisconsin Badgers earlier this year. They'll go with a three wide receiver set, no tight end, and the I formation. Give it to Maurice Morris. Maurice, boy, he just hammers his way to the 25-yard line.
Really has been the workhorse in the first half of the Ducks.
Morris, left side, with an opening. First down to the 34-yard line.
You know, Morris runs hard, a little bit like last year's Ruben Drones. Drones was not a flashy runner right there. A little misdirection once again. They caught UCLA in a blitz. But Morris just runs hard. He tries to get up the field vertically. So far, you'd think Deshaun Foster, the Heisman candidate, would have a bunch. Only 2.6 yard average, 42 yards on the day.
Keenan Howery goes in motion. They'll run it right side. And again, Morris slips by the first would-be tackler, gains two on the play, but that's all. It'll be second down and long. Tony White.
Some not-so-good news for the Oregon Duck defense. Safety Ryan Mitchell is down for the game. That right ankle sprain was just more than he could handle. He's on the sideline on crutches. Will not return. Steve.
And they've been playing a cornerback in his spot, Lisa. Brian Johnson, Steve Smith have been in the game with Rasuli Webster. Right now on offense, Howery in motion, second down. 8 yards to go. Harrington has to scramble and has to throw it away.
Harrington himself has been forced with a lot of third and longs.
UCLA showing a four-man rush, then a flag goes down.
The crowd was directly responsible for all five. That time a false start on the Ducks. It pushes them back even further. Third and 13.
Well, he has some burners in the game with Tucker and Howery both on the left side. Let's see if Keenan goes in motion. No, he'll stay left. Deep drop by Harrington. They throw to Morris. What they knew. Bob Field, who is the defensive coordinator for UCLA, he said the two biggest things we talk about are number one, getting 11 guys to play smart, and number two, playing hard all the time. They're seeing that this year. He believes they've just grown up. They've always had the talent. And there'll be a penalty here because they did not allow Ricky Manning to cover the football. Flag because they didn't give Ricky Manning any room to catch that football.
Well, Ricky Manning called the fair catch, and one of the Bruins is trying to get a block. Kevin Brandt, number 32. Actually, it's Wes Mallard, number 18. The ball, maybe that's using your head there, Wes.
Our first touching by the kicking team. That's the spot of first touching. The ball was ultimately recovered by Oregon, but the ball will go to UCLA. That's the spot of first touching. First down.
It'll upset the crowd, but it's a completely rational, completely legal call. Curtis Dorr hit a great punt, and it's who it hits first. And it hits Wes Mallard. Watch his helmet. Bonk. Number 18.
Just like downing the football. As soon as Mallard hit it with his head. Needing a touchdown to tie. Deshaun Foster, the lone setback. Play action. McCann swings it to his tight end, incomplete at the 44-yard line. McCann has completed just two of his last 10 passes for 24 yards. I formation. Again, play action. Coley Dixon and Brian muscles his way near the 46-yard line. Still, as you see, that Verizon marker, 2 yards.
And Drew Bennett, if they're smart, they run a little option play action.
And they throw the football. Drew will do just that. Downfield, wide open, Freddie Mitchell. See you later.
What a great call. Take a look at the in sync. You got to be when you pull this one off. Drew Bennett, little dip into the line. And that's why Bob Toledo goes back. You said it. Riverboat gambler, toss it to Freddie Mitchell. He'll take it the distance. Great work.
So UCLA with a chance to tie this game after being down 10-0 at halftime. And Drew Bennett shakes his fist to the heavens as he just held for the point after touchdown. And he takes the option, and what happens, Tom?
Boy, Freddie Mitchell comes down like he's going to block. All of a sudden, he runs right by Brian Johnson. Great pass and catch right there. Drew Bennett sold it really well, sold the option. They coming down the line.
Have the offense.
Against the kicking team.
In discussion once again.
Illegal equipment is two identical numbers on the kicking team.
Pixie just drilled it through the end zone, and Oregon was going to start their offense at the 20-yard line. Now they may get it at the 5 and have a chance for a strong return.
Feels like he has a little wind to his back.
Well, he does. He's got a heck of a leg from the goal line. Sonny Cook to the 20. Sonny Cook to the 35. To the 36. So it's a gain of 16 because of the... Here's number 6, UCLA, trying to come from behind against the Oregon Ducks. UCLA blitzing. Harrington stepping up. Marshawn Tucker incomplete.
Showing such great timing that time, closing on the ball. Marshawn Tucker running a post, getting a two-man route to bring a lot of heat up the middle, pushing the pocket a little bit. Jason Bell does a great job because he keeps his eye on the ball the entire time. Once it leaves Harrington's hands, Bell picks it up. He's able to time it, make the play.
2nd and 10. Harrington drills it to Keenan Howery. First down at midfield. Zdenek on the tackle.
Much nice. Watch him turn protect here. They move the pocket once again, and it buys Harrington a little more time. But what UCLA is doing now, when they see the pocket move, they're bringing the backers up on a blitz, and you're going to see some collisions now. They're going to go after Harrington. They don't want him to buy that extra time.
They'll stay 3 wide receiver set. No tight end. Harrington throws. Howery against Marcus Anderson. First
down Oregon.
Mallory, he's a great move guy, and this is all you do. You want to get him in the open field. Watch the move he puts on Marcus Anderson. Just goes right around him. Tries to shake and bake Ricky Manny, but Manny just holds his ground and then uses the sideline as his help.
Boy, he came from that great passing offense at Los Alamitos High School in Southern California. Now play action again. Harrington's keeping it in the air. Marshawn Tucker broken up beautifully. Joe Hunter
timing it out, making a great play from the deep safety position. Harrington stands tall again in the pocket. Watch Joe Hunter come from the safety position. He just reads ball the whole way, bats the ball away. It's contact after he knocks the ball away. Watch this. Hunter comes in, his hand will go up, bat it away. Plus, he's there ready to strip the ball out in case Tucker does come down with it.
Bruins bring the blitz. Incomplete. Harrington, a little bit of time.
By Ricky Manning. Keenan Howery motions out of the backfield. They try to get him on a wheel route up the sideline. Just one-on-one, and what's surprising, Ricky Manning got his head around late, but such great reaction. This is a great look at it. Once the ball hits Howery's hands, up goes Manning's arms to drive the ball out of the way. Harrington thought he had one there.
Wow. They're going for it on fourth down. Joey, LaCorey Collins, did he hold on? Yes, he did. He was fighting with Marcus Anderson for that football on the sideline.
Well, you know, it's great. LaCorey Collins is a great big-time player out of Skyline High School in Oakland, California. They spot him in duty now and then, but when they bring him in the game, they always usually throw him a ball. Well, I don't blame him. I'd go his way, too. That's a big-time reception right there by LaCorey Collins.
UCLA showing blitz. Harrington quick pass, Keenan Howery, and Anderson pulls him down. He has a second and 11 here. Morris, the lone setback. Harrington options. Morris, 15 out of bounds near the 14-yard line. They need to get to just past the 7-yard line for a first down. Again, the option. Morris to the 10. He is very close to a first down.
The option down the line. Nice call once again. And Morris, the ball, he actually goes out of bounds about a yard shy, and he just leaned forward, put the ball out. That's where the referee spotted it. Let Frankel gain a little confidence again. It's a chip shot, 24 yards. He put points on the board right here.
Josh off to the right side, and it is good. 24 yards out. Now Tab Perry, past the 25, past the 30, to the 35-yard line.
Tab Perry just has soft hands. He just catches it. He's always walking around. He has a football, always carrying one around. And he should, too. Don't let that ball come out right there. Interesting so far. Oregon's bunched up the middle right here. They've made it awfully difficult for UCLA to rush the ball today on first down.
Deshaun Foster, nothing. Kevin Mitchell, the outside backer. Lisa, what do you have?
Well, Steve, just wanted to let you know about the sound meter. We've been keeping an eye on things. The highest it's gone was 107, which is near the sound of a power saw. But here in the second half, it's been a little quieter, in the 90s mostly. Steve?
I want you to know that a normal conversation, Lisa, is 60 decibels. Jet engine is 140. Look at the rocket. Play action. Blitz on. McCann has to just get rid of it. Saul Patu was in his face.
Second, third down, led Oregon in QB sacks the last 2 years. The senior statesman, 35 career starts.
He
He was great in that Sun Bowl last year with three tackles behind the line of scrimmage. Now third and 10. McCann. They sack him. Blitz by Steve Smith, who came over the top.
You know what makes it so hard to pick up blitzes is when they come from the outside. They come off the corner. Steve Smith gonna come in. Almost comes unblocked. They just bring guys off the corner. The unaccounted for defender, he comes and just goes up high on McCann and sacks him.
Pixie hammers this one. Keenan Howery tries the middle. Keenan Howery past midfield. Cut down at the 45.
His own guy got him.
Or he was gone.
Keith Lewis, the special teams bean hump, got in Howery's way. A good punt, but the outkick coverage right here. UCLA had two men down. Good blocks by Oregon. Then Howery takes it right up the middle. He's gone all the way. Except for Lewis trips him.
You know what? Mike Bellotti said yesterday, Keith Lewis is an exciting young player. True freshman. He's either going to make a play that is brilliant or a play that you go, uh-oh. Well, that was one of the uh-ohs from the 44. Maurice Morris cut down. Oh, look at that surge by UCLA. Second down, 13 yards to go. Harrington swinging it to his wide receiver. And Sammy Parker, the redshirt freshman from Long Beach Poly High School.
That's the big issue.
And they haven't won in 2 years. Harrington trying to break away. First down inside the 30-yard line. Ken Coker grabbed him by the jersey and kept him from breaking away.
Well, on third down at the point of attack, you don't want your defensive lineman. Keep an eye on Ken Coker, 97 right here. You don't want him to get pushed down the field. And right here, he tries to scrape down the line of scrimmage. They get into his legs, but he's got those big paws. He's able to get a hold of Harrington, but Harrington's 220 pounds.
Either Harrington keeping it or Maurice Morris taking it. Oregon has seen the football a lot more. They'll run Willis. Willis escaping right. A lot more trick plays as Jason Willis very close to a first down.
Really something to change it up. Just a little mini reverse from the H-back position. Nice play call once again. The red zone. Oregon State very innovative.
They've already started a march to the other end zone. Oregon saw UCLA tie this game at 10 with 10 straight points in the second half. Steve Fizziok along with Tom Ramsey. But you like the creativity of Mike Bellotti. He didn't play not to lose this game.
And I like their decisiveness, too. They've been going for it on fourth down. They've been in the red zone. They've been running reverses. They've been running the option. They've been going after the 6 points. And I tell you right now, no time to hold back if you're Oregon.
And Oregon right now will head out on offense. Second down, 6 yards to go. Harrington getting it outside. Again, they will go to Jason Willis. And Willis, a wide receiver, has carried the football 4 times in this game. And this is the first time he has not had real positive yardage.
And what's interesting, Steve, they've been using Willis out of the backfield running the option, which has been pretty interesting, but it's one more way to get his athleticism on the field. Take a look at the game summary. Oregon 307 total yards, 0 turnovers. UCLA only 187 total yards, 2 turnovers. Morris outrushing the Heisman hopeful Deshaun Foster, 104-42. And Oregon right now looking to hold on to 16 straight wins at home, which is number 5 in the nation.
Right is Justin Peel. Harrington looking for Peel, then drops it off to Morris. Morris escapes one, still on his feet. They say he went down. A knee was down at the 11-yard line.
I watch UCLA. They attack him. Watch and see if his knee is down here.
Ooh.
Well, he lost his shoe. And the
referees ran on the play on the sideline. It all happens pretty quick.
I don't know if he touched.
Awfully close.
On the way. Good. Oregon takes a 16-10 lead over the number six UCLA Bruins. Consecutive home game, their last loss here at Autzen against these UCLA Bruins. Jermaine Lewis from the 14. Jermaine Lewis isn't going anywhere. The crowd picks up. Deshaun Foster cuts back. Deshaun Foster up near the 24-yard line.
Times in the first half, and now the crowd starting to get back into it.
Second and five may help out, taking that blitz off McCann. They'll run Foster again, not much.
This may be Oregon. Their defense is big time, too. Matt Smith, number 49, on the blitz. Inside, he just reads it, picks his hole out, and tackles Foster for about a yard gain.
Crowd really loud now. Third down. McCann, shotgun, four wide receivers. With that 15 mile an hour wind. Howery fumbles, recovers it himself. There is a flag down.
Howery.
Non-contact interference with the right to catch the ball. Be a 5-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
The call is non-contact. See right there where the Bruin went slipping by Howery, really to distract him more than anything else. Well, you can't do that. You have to give the receiver of that punt 2 yards.
UCLA has Cal, Arizona, and at Washington on the road left. Harrington giving it to Morris. Morris spun down by Tony White, who's been all over the past two possessions after UCLA came back to tie it, resulted in a field goal. Harrington swings it out. This is young Parker, and Sammy escapes for very close to a first down. Let's see where they mark it. No, it'll be about 2 yards shy. Will they run that option? Yep. Morris, nice cutback. First down. Morris inside the 30 to the 27.
They use this play. Watch the misdirection. Everything's going this way. The back goes this way, and it's just a quick pitch by the quarterback, Harrington. Just a little deception in the offense. Totally breaks all the tendencies, and right there, Maurice Morris having a great day. Over 100 yards for the day.
They're already in field goal range. 121 yards. Morris finds another hole to the 25. He is dead center, middle of the field. Steve Morgan, a reserve defensive tackle, makes the stop.
When, if you don't think Mike Bellotti has one eye on the field and one eye on the clock, you're mistaken.
Fires right. There's Jason Wills. He has played a lot in this game. Running the football, catching the football.
This goes back to being a boxer. Here you go. Take what the opponent gives you. If they're going to sit back 10 yards, take a hitch out in front. Harrington, a quick three-step drop. No chance of getting sacked. Just fires the ball out to Willis, making Ricky Manning catch the ball 10 yards down the field.
But again, very creative. They lead by six. They're not just 3 yards in a cloud of dust, or here, a cloud of sand. Here's Harrington throwing it. His receiver had turned a little too late, or Sammy Parker would have had it near the 5-yard inside. 9 minutes to go. Harrington has been efficient. Again, no turnovers. Morris, big hole. He's to the five. He's close to a first down.
Offensive line, really the unsung heroes today. They do a nice job locking people up.
You know, we talked about Deshaun Foster carrying it 30-35 times. This young man from South Carolina has now carried it 31 times for 132 yards. 200 yards rushing to 23. You can't say enough about that offensive line for Oregon. Josh Line. Looks like he got the first down.
And Steve, talking to Neil Zimbukas, the offensive line coach for Oregon, before the game, he said, you know, we're a bit of a patchwork group. We don't have any, you know, All-Americans or All-Stars up front, but I tell you, there's a bunch of hard workers. Jim Adams, Ryan Smith, Jeff Austin, Lee Gundy, the big tackle, number 76. They've been doing a good job of at least neutralizing the defensive line of UCLA.
And both tackles, Gundy and Adams, are playing with broken hands. Double tight end. Josh Line finally pulled down around the 2-yard line. Morris leaps the top. He is in for the Oregon touchdown.
All the games are determined at the line of scrimmage. Almost every football game. Who owns the line of scrimmage? Right now, the Oregon Ducks have taken full control of the line of scrimmage. Over 200 yards rushing, only 23 for UCLA, and that equates into a lot of different factors.
Harrington, play action, scrambling, incomplete. Welcome you back to Autzen Stadium in Eugene, Oregon, where the Ducks surprising the number 6 team in the nation, UCLA, 22-10, 6.5 minutes remaining. Ryan McCann needs to get it done right now. McCann said last week, I think we proved we're the number 1 team in the nation by beating Michigan and Alabama, 2 number 3s. I don't know what else we have to do, he said. I don't know what else we can do. Ryan, you better beat Oregon. McCann deep. Freddie Mitchell, first down midfield. How did he get that open? But there is a flag down back at the 15.
Offside on the Ducks, declined.
Defensive test. 22-10. Ducks lead. McCann. With time. Incomplete. Brian Fletcher stretched out but could not bring it in.
Watch Fletcher get down the field from the tight end position. Running a nice route right between the hash marks. The ball doesn't come out of McCann's hands great, but I tell you, Fletcher's got to come down with that. Fletcher just in and out.
McCann has had a couple of drops of big plays. Dubrovic for a touchdown in the first half. Second and 10. Oregon blitzing. Flag down. There's someone in the neutral zone because they had a terrific edge.
That's all. Ball start. On the offense. 5 yards.
Boy.
Down the field two.
Six false starts.
Six false starts. Ryan McCann, they got a blitz on. He just gets crushed. Wes Mallard again, number 18, coming from the linebacker spot.
Rashad Bowman, single coverage on Freddie Mitchell. McCann rolling away from pressure. Going deep, Freddie Mitchell. Incomplete. Rashad Bowman is one tough son of a gun. Here's a guy started as a true freshman, played as a sophomore, missed all last year because of a terrible knee injury. He is 5'7" tall, but man, can he play.
And look, UCLA, they're bringing out the punt team. Steve, I disagree with this. If you're the number six ranked team in the country, you gotta take two downs. You gotta go for it. You don't have time on your side.
4:59 to go. Fixie. Howery will bring it back. He is dropped to the 31-yard line. You're right, the only gain about 25 yards. For UCLA, they had to quiet the crowd with a quick start. Didn't do that. Win the turnover battle. They have turned the ball over twice. Run Deshaun Foster successfully. He has barely cracked 40 yards rushing. Meantime, Morris, getting the call here, has gone over 130 yards. Second and 7 after a gain of 3 by Maurice Morris. Now it's time to run Morris every time. Maurice gets it, and whoo, who was that? That was Robert Thomas, the middle linebacker. Third and seven. Big series defensively. They pitch it to Morris, and he will not escape the Bruins.
UCLA call timeout right now.
And they do. But Curtis Doar hammers it. Oregon special teams have been special this afternoon. And there's a fumble. UCLA covers it. Ricky Manning fumbled the football, may have gotten it back himself. Also diving in there was Marcus Anderson, his teammate.
Curtis Doar makes UCLA go the long field.
Fumble, McCann trying to cover it. It's still on the field. Picked up by Oregon at the 5-yard line. Matt Smith, the middle linebacker, covers the football. A poor exchange from Danoff to the quarterback McCann, but there is a flag down. That is
flag,
the third
flag,
UCLA turnover.
A flag, frustration, and a personal foul. You see Ryan McCann tries to go after the ball. Danoff never got it up. The ball squirts out, and Matt Smith picks it up, and then there's a ruckus that follows.
Dead ball, both fouls are dead ball fouls. Both fouls are personal against the defense. Dead ball personal against the offense. Both fouls offset. First down and 10. First down and goal.
I know what I wouldn't have done. Boy, Matt Smith, number 49, the veteran linebacker. He's been such a leader. He's down right there, but then Mike Safer comes over and just hammers him, draws the flag, creates the ruckus. First down, Oregon.
UCLA not quitting as they hammer him at the 6-yard line. Clock winds down to 2:51. It's much improved, and it's really because juniors, seniors, and really good quarterbacks.
A lot of good quarterbacks, that's for sure. They put more in to the NFL than any other conference in the league. And I'm sure Harrington and his backup, A.J. Feely, will get their respective time at the next level.
Look at this. Maurice Morris, the running back of the day. All the talk about Deshaun Foster, and he is a great one. But it was Maurice Morris who played like Foster today with 37 carries in this game for 139 yards.
Great job up front.
Oregon running away from number 6 UCLA. 37 carries, 139 yards. I mean, Bilotti goes out and gets the best junior college running backs in the country.
Made the right adjustments at halftime, too. 19 points, and UCLA had the goose egg in the second half.
Jermaine Lewis at the 15. Lewis, not much. Their special teams, their efficiency has been so good. Oregon has played one of those games where if you're going to beat them, you better beat them, because they have not made any mistakes in this game. McCann backing up. McCann trying to escape. He is sacked back at the 18 by Seth McEwen.
Nick Aliotti, the defensive coordinator, making a bit of a statement today with his troops. A lot of guys, kind of the no-name defense, if you will.
The third sack of the game. Second in a row. This time, Saul Patu.
They expect him to have a great year. He comes looping in from the defensive end position. Little tackle end stunt there.
Third down. McCann, this time with time, trying to find Paulie Dixon. Intercepted. No, they say he was out of bounds. What a job they have done on Deshaun Foster and UCLA's defense. We asked Nick Aliotti yesterday, who's the best running back in the conference? And he said, number one, Deshaun Foster. And he said, number two, Marquez Tuiasosopo. And Tuiasosopo's a quarterback, and they get him next week.
They get him, but, you know, they best keep an eye on the other gentleman up the road, Kenny Simonton, averaging about 192 yards a game for Oregon State.
Here's the punt. Howry dropped at midfield. Just 39 seconds remaining in this contest. Yeah, Oregon, they've got Murderers Row coming up with Washington, then at USC. The last win over a number 16 by Oregon. They beat Washington 3 years ago, 31-28. Now, Harrington will go to one knee. Toledo, his team has beaten Alabama. They have beaten Michigan. He was asked if they could contend for the national championship. Bob said, we have not executed like we need to make a run at it. Today, they did not execute because of that man's defense. The celebration begins, and the fans on the field, not one of them left Autzen Stadium. And Oregon has won their 17th consecutive home game.